Potassium is an essential mineral and electrolyte in your body. Around 98% of potassium in your body is found inside your cells. Of the 98%, 80% is found inside your skeletal muscle, 20% in bone, red blood cells, and liver. It is involved in muscle contractions, heart function, and regulating water balance. A diet rich in potassium may help lower high blood pressure, reduce risk of stroke, as well as prevent osteoporosis and kidney stones. A healthy adult should aim to consume 4,700 milligrams of potassium daily from food. Welcome back. My name is Lucy. I'm a pharmacist and a nurse. In this video, we will talk about the 10 signs you may have low potassium. What causes low potassium? Your body can lose too much potassium from diarrhea or vomiting. It can be caused by some medications like water pill, laxatives, certain antibiotics like amphotericin B and penicillin, corticosteroids, albuterol, normally used in asthma patient, or insulin overdose. It can also be as a result of excessive sweating, excessive alcohol consumption, certain medical conditions such as diabetes, ketoacidosis, chronic kidney disease, and Cushing's syndrome. Also, lack of potassium in the diet can sometimes cause deficiencies. What are the signs of low potassium? Fatigue and weakness are the most common symptoms of low potassium and often the very first sign. Low level of potassium result in the muscle producing weaker contractions. This can affect the way our body uses up other nutrients and can affect energy production. All this leads to weakness and fatigue over time. The second sign is muscle cramps, aches, and stiffness. Potassium helps relay signals from the brain to stimulate muscle contractions and also end them eventually. When you have low potassium, this process is affected and we experience more prolonged contractions and hence muscle cramps, aches, and stiffness. Low potassium can also cause abdominal cramping or bloating, and this is because low potassium levels can slow your digestive system. Also, low potassium can cause constipation. This is because low potassium causes the smooth muscles of your digestive system to weaken. If you're drinking enough water and eating enough fiber and still constipated, it could be because of low potassium. It is good to note that too much potassium can also cause the same effect. Number five is heart palpitation. While heart palpitation can be as a result of stress or anxiety, they are also linked to low potassium. The flow of potassium in and out of the heart cells regulates heartbeat. When potassium is not present in sufficient amounts, this flow is altered, leading to palpitations. Also, you may experience ringing or vibrating sensation in your ears, which is a secondary symptom of palpitation. Abnormal heart rhythm are the most worrisome complication, especially in patients with underlying heart disease. Number six is high blood pressure. Potassium is important for regulation of blood pressure because potassium lessens the effect of sodium. The more potassium you eat, the more sodium you lose through urine, which that reduces the amount of fluid you have in your body and hence low blood pressure. Potassium also helps to ease tension in your blood vessel walls, which helps further lower blood pressure. Number seven is brain fog, forgetfulness, and confusion. Low level of potassium can interfere with normal electrical activity in the brain, which can cause overall feeling of confusion, sluggishness in thinking, and inability to concentrate. Number eight is tingling or numbness. This often occurs in the hands, arms, legs, and feet. This is because low potassium levels can weaken nerve signals. Number nine is excessive urination and thirst. Excessive urination and feeling of thirst is common when the body's sodium level is also low. This causes the kidney's ability to retain urine to decrease, and the body loses its ability to regulate water balance, which can create feeling of frequent urination and extreme thirst. Number 10, so the last sign of low potassium, is difficulty breathing. Breathing requires the use of several muscles, such as the diaphragm. If your potassium levels become very low, these muscles may not work properly. You may have difficulty taking a deep breath or may feel very short of breath. A healthy adult should aim to consume 4,700 milligrams of potassium, and it is better to take potassium through nutrition than a pill because nutrition has a better balance. Potassium is found in various foods, which we will discuss in the upcoming video. Thank you for watching. Like and share the video and subscribe to the channel if you like this kind of content.